Hey guys, Madison here, and today I'm watching North by Northwest, directed by Alfred Hitchcock. 3 months ago, I watched Rear Window, and I really, really enjoyed it, and I want to keep throwing in these classic older films every now and again, so I'm really excited to give this one a watch. Before I get started with this week's reaction, I want to say thank you guys so, so much, because I've hit 14,000 subscribers. You guys just keep blowing me away. Let's keep pushing on to 15,000. Next week, I want to go ahead and let you guys know there is not going to be a new reaction because I'm going on vacation next week, so no new reaction. But I do have a question for you guys, because there was a time of probably several months when I was not on YouTube posting reactions because my channel was demonetized, there was all this drama, and I was like, screw this, you know, I'm gonna go post my videos somewhere else. So I have this whole archive of reactions that have not been posted on YouTube. And so I'm considering moving those reactions over, re-editing them according to YouTube's rules, and posting them on YouTube. Would you guys like to see those? Because I have a lot of great reactions that most of my audience has not seen. And there are several of them that people keep recommending to me, and I'm like, I've already seen that, and they don't even know it. I've already reacted to it. I have really great films in the archive, like The Matrix and The Sixth Sense and Rocky. I have lots of films that I've reacted to, and they're not here on YouTube. They are before I got my nice new camera, so they're my iPhone old quality reactions. They are before I moved to this new location, this new room where I'm recording. So the quality is not the same as my new reactions, but I wanted to put that out there and ask you guys, would you like to see me post those reactions here on YouTube where everyone can get to them easily? Because right now they're all on Rumble and most of y'all are not over there, so I want my reactions to be accessible to everyone and for everyone to get to enjoy them. And then when I have weeks like next week where I'm on vacation, maybe I can re-edit old reactions and post them so that there's still something for you guys to watch. Because I've got several. I think it's at least 10 reactions over there that I would love to share with you guys. So let me know if y'all would be interested in me re-editing those and posting them over here on YouTube. Or no, just keep moving forward with the new reactions. Don't bother posting the old ones, because it would throw off the order, which bothers someone like me, where all the Film Fridays are like listed in order. It would be like Film Friday 42 and then going back to Film Friday number 30. But anyway, let me know what you guys think, if you want to see those reactions posted here on YouTube, or no, just keep moving on with the new stuff. So let me know in the comments below what you guys would like me to do about that. And without further ado, guys, I'm really excited to watch this movie. I always know with Alfred Hitchcock, I'm not going to go wrong. So let's check out North by Northwest.
I beg your pardon. I have a very sick woman here. You don't mind, do you?
Well, no. Perfectly all right.
First, stop the plaza. Don't show the flag.
I knew you were lying.
Maggie, in the world of advertising, there's no such thing as a lie. There's only the expedient exaggeration. You ought to know that. I feel heavy-ish. Put a note on my desk in the morning. Think thin.
Think thin.
Well, she's playing bridge at the apartment of one of her cronies.
Your secretary?
No, hey, my mother.
Cars waiting outside. You will walk between us, saying nothing.
What are you talking about?
Let's go.
The status took a very bad turn for him.
Couldn't we stop off at a drugstore for a moment so that I can explain I'm being kidnapped? Well, that is what's happening, isn't it?
He's very chill about being kidnapped.
Who's Townsend? Really? Interesting.
I could only hope that I would have my wits about me so that I could sass my kidnappers as epically as he is.
You will wait here.
Well, don't hurry. I'll catch up on my reading.
Lester Townsend. Why is Townsend such a good, like, villain name? It just is. Something so rich and ominous about it.
Not what I expected. A little taller. A little more polished than the others.
Oh, I'm so glad you're pleased, Mr. Townsend. Not that I mind a slight case of abduction now and then, but I have tickets for the theater this evening. To a show I was looking forward to.
My secretary is a great admirer of your methods, Mr. Kaplan.
Mr. Kaplan?
My name is Thornhill. Roger Thornhill. There's never been anything else.
Of course. I don't really expect you to fall in with this suggestion, but the least I can do is afford you the opportunity of surviving the evening.
Why do they think he's Kaplan?
It'll be easier if you take this yourself. Otherwise, it'll be necessary for us to insist.
Tall glasses, porn.
I brought a custard to my bourbon. Your bourbon.
No shape to escape now. Yeah, they were gonna make it look like he had a drunk driving incident and just died, drove off a cliff. This is gonna be interesting. Oh my gosh. This is terrifying in the first person view. This is really an incredible feat by him.
They try to kill me. No, he won't listen to me.
Okay. Yeah, they're not gonna believe him because he's drunk as all get out. Maybe they'll believe him when he's not. Probably not, though.
Sit down. We'll get him. We'll throw a book at him. Assault and kidnapping. Assault with a gun and a bourbon and a sports car. We'll get him.
You're allowed one call. Over here.
Oh, thanks.
Better make it your lawyer.
Make it a good one.
Oh, Mother? Mother, this is your son, Roger Thornhill. Where am I?
Glen Cove Police Station.
Glen Cove Police Station.
Stick out your tongue and say, ah.
You better move back.
Ah! Have you been drinking?
Doctor, I am gassed.
What were you?
The county detectives will determine if his story has any basis in fact.
Basis in fact?
How's he gonna prove it? Unless anyone in that hotel lobby area, like, saw him get dragged outside by those two guys.
Remember me? This is the cabinet where they keep the liquor. Scotch, gin, vodka.
And bourbon.
Roger, dear, we were so worried about you. Did you get home all right?
Well, where's her husband? He's the one you should be questioning.
Is there any place he can be reached?
Why, yes. The United Nations.
United Nations?
Oh, boy.
All right, so do you mean you're not going to do any more about this?
Roger, pay the $2.
Covered all their tracks.
Goodbye.
You just keep smiling, Mrs. Townsend. You're going to get yours.
Go to the desk and get the key to 796.
Don't be ridiculous. I wouldn't do such a thing.
$10?
Not for all the money in the world.
50?
Roger, you are disgraceful. Will you want me to be changing your bed, sir?
Yes, but not right now. She seemed to think I'm Kaplan. I wonder if I look like Kaplan. Oh, well, look who's here.
Who? Where?
Our friend who's assembling the General Assembly this afternoon.
Roger, I think we should go. I'll be late for the bridge club.
Good. You'll lose less than usual.
Where's the real George Kaplan?
Kaplan has dandruff.
In that case, I think we should leave.
When did you first see me?
Outside the door. On the hall a couple of minutes ago.
And how'd you know I'm Mr. Kaplan?
What?
How'd you know I'm Mr. Kaplan?
Well, of course you are.
You called on the phone and
described the suit to me and said it would be hanging in your closet. Like you always do. Mm-hmm. Anything wrong?
I'm beginning to think that no one in the hotel has actually seen Kaplan.
Yeah.
Maybe he has his suits mended by invisible weavers. Ah, now that's much better.
Well, obviously, they've mistaken me for a much shorter man.
You answer his telephone, you live in his hotel room, and yet you are not Mr. Kaplan. Nevertheless, we are pleased to find you in.
Now, wait. It was from the lobby. They're probably on their way up here right now. Come on, let's get out of here.
I think I'd like to meet these killers.
I don't think you would.
You gentlemen aren't really trying to kill my son, are you?
He's like, I'm living in the Twilight Zone. It's enough to drive a man insane, having people trying to kill you and no one believes you.
Take me to the United Nations.
Right.
General Assembly Building.
Mr. Kaplan.
Yes?
You wanted to see Mr. Townsend.
Yes.
This is Mr. Townsend.
How do you do, Mr. Kaplan?
This is Mr. Townsend.
What?
Oh, I've been staying in my apartment here in town for the last month. I always do when we're in session here.
So they, like,
what about Mrs. Townsend?
Pretended?
My wife.
Do you know this man?
What? So these people just moved into Townsend's house and did a completely fake operation. Oh my gosh. This is escalating quickly. How could anyone think it was him? He was just standing there talking to him. There had to be someone who saw the guy run up with a knife. I mean, come on.
I'm gonna get mistaken for George Kaplan when George Kaplan doesn't even exist.
Ask me how it happened. Obviously it happened.
Our non-existent decoy, George Kaplan, created to divert suspicion from our actual agent, has fortuitously become a live decoy.
Goodbye, Mr. Thornhill, wherever you are.
Huh. Well, I can't go to the police. My fingerprints are on the knife, I'm a car thief, a drunk driver, and I murdered a man for revenge. I wouldn't have a chance. Oh, you want me to jump off a moving plane? Yes, well, thank you so much, Mother. Goodbye.
Something wrong with your eyes?
Yes, they're sensitive to questions. Will you call them?
Don't go away.
He's at window 15, upper level. Hurry.
You're in luck, mistake.
He went that way. I think he got off.
Thank you.
It's quite all right.
7 parking tickets.
Oh.
Helped him out.
You feel you've seen me somewhere before. Funny how I have that effect on people. It's something about my face.
It's a nice face.
Oh, you're that type.
Not really.
Good, because all these women frighten me.
What? I'm Eve Kendall. I'm 26 and unmarried. Now you know everything.
Tell me, what do you do besides lure men to their doom on the 20th Century Limited?
I'm an industrial designer. You're Roger Thornhill of Madison Avenue, and you're wanted for murder on every front page in America.
So is she the government's agent, or is she going to be a bad agent working for the villains who are trying to kill him? I don't know which yet.
This train seems to be making an unscheduled stop, and I just saw 2 men get out of a police car as we pulled into the station. They weren't smiling.
Patience is a virtue.
He's always breathing.
Just lie still.
Have you got any olive oil?
Your waiter said that you were getting along pretty good with this Thornhill fellow.
Oh, is that his name, Thornhill? All we did was chat about different kinds of food, train travel versus plane travel, that sort of thing.
We'll be in the observation car at the rear of the train.
It's comforting to know that. Good night.
Stone cold. She's definitely an agent.
Hello there.
Hello there.
It's not safe for you to roam around Chicago looking for this George Kaplan man you've been telling me about. Now, don't you think it'll be a better idea if you stayed in my hotel room while I located him for you?
Can he not tell that she's some kind of agent, or maybe he knows and he just doesn't care? Offering to find Kaplan and all that.
Only one bed.
Yes.
You know what that means?
Hmm.
What? Tell me.
It means you're going to sleep on the floor.
A message from the lady in 3901.
Okay, first assumption, she's working for the bad guy, but what if she's the government agent they were talking about who's pretending to work for the bad guy and she's undercover, so she's actually a good guy, not a bad guy.
I think we made it.
Where did he go?
Took the poles and went up that way.
Come on!
You to take the Greyhound bus that leaves Chicago for Indianapolis at 2 and ask the driver to let you off at Prairie Stop, Highway 41.
Wait a minute. Please.
They're coming.
Out in the middle of nowhere now. Perfect place to kill someone and dispose of the body. Plane?
Are you supposed to be meeting someone here?
Waiting for the bus. Due any minute.
Oh.
That's funny.
What?
That plane's dusting crops where there ain't no crops.
Oh my gosh. Who's flying this plane? That's a good idea. Oh no. Gonna smoke him out. Now we'll never know who was flying that plane. That truck just almost straight up ran him over. This is crazy, man.
Surprised?
Yes.
He didn't show up.
Oh?
It's funny, isn't it?
Why funny?
Well, that wouldn't it be nice if my problems and your plans were somehow connected? Then we could always stay close to each other.
I want you to leave right now. Stay far away from me and don't come near me again.
After dinner, fair is fair.
All right.
I think she's the undercover government agent. She's trying to protect him now. the man she's working for is trying to kill him.
How does a girl like you get to be a girl like you? Naughty, wicked, up to no good. Ever kill anyone? Because I bet you could tease a man to death without half trying.
Smart.
Please start the bidding. How much? 800 is offered.
The three of you together. Now, that's a picture only Charles Adams could draw.
Good evening, Mr. Kaplan.
He was in your room?
Sure, isn't everybody?
150, thank you. Now I'll say the two. Do I hear two?
I didn't realize you were an art collector. I thought you just collected corpses. Do I hear
five? 500.
Now, she puts her heart into her work. In fact, her whole body. Who are you kidding? You have no feelings to hurt.
Please start the bidding.
Mr. Kaplan, we've had just about enough of you.
Sold for $22.50. And now?
$22.50 for that chromo? How do we know it's not a fake? It looks like a fake.
12 is bid. I have 12. Go 13. Who'll say 13?
$13. Make it 2,500.
Ask him to leave.
You trying to get removed by the police? The lengths this man is going to survive.
You're about to become heroes. Chicago police capture United Nations killer. My name is Roger Thornhill.
It's him.
That's right. Congratulations, Ben.
Proceeding north to 42nd Precinct. What?
Where are we going?
Airport.
What?
Orders.
The airport. Airport?
Well, didn't you hear what I said? I want to be taken to police headquarters. I'm a dangerous assassin. I'm a loose. You ought to be a...
Thought I'd never make it. I'm getting too old for this kind of work. All right, men. Thank you. This way, Mr. Thornhill.
We haven't much time. Is that one of the guys who was in the FBI meeting?
FBI, CIA, ONI, we're all in the same alphabet soup.
Well, you can stick this in your alphabet soup.
Well, where are we going? New York or Washington?
Rapid City, South Dakota.
Rapid City? What for?
Set his mind at ease about George Kaplan.
You're George Kaplan, aren't you?
There is no such person as George Kaplan.
What do you mean there's no such person? I've been in his hotel room. I've tried on his clothes. He's got short sleeves and dandruff.
Believe me, Mr. Thornhill, he doesn't exist. Once found out, they're as good as dead. Thanks to you, clouds of suspicion are already forming. If I thought there was any chance of changing your mind, I'd talk about Miss Kendall, of whom you so obviously disapprove. You see, Mr. Thornhill, she's one of our agents.
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. Mount Rushmore, haven't been there in several years.
I want the girl. I want the girl to get what's coming to her.
Stay away from me. Let go. Let go of me.
I saved her from the tears.
What? Did they plan this? That's right, he said we're gonna ease his mind about George Kaplan, so he's gonna think George Kaplan is dead, and then Thornhill is free to live, free to go about his business. They're pulling a sting on me, if you know what I mean.
Mr. Thornhill?
Of course I was hurt. How would you have felt?
I mean, in the cafeteria, when you fell, when I shot you with the blanks.
Oh, that? No. I thought I was quite graceful.
I met Philip Van Damme at a party one night and saw only his charm. I guess I had nothing to do that weekend, so I decided to fall in love. And he told me that my relationship with him made me uniquely valuable to them. Mm-hmm. Maybe it was the first time anyone ever asked me to do anything worthwhile. They don't believe in marriage.
I've been married twice.
See what I mean? Well, he has told you, hasn't he?
Told me what?
Miss Kendall, you got to get moving.
Is she going with him?
Why didn't you?
She's going off with Van Damme tonight on the plane.
If you fellas can't lick the Van Dams of this world without asking girls like her to bed down with them and fly away with them and probably never come back, perhaps you ought to start learning how to lose a few cold wars.
What's this?
Well, that's where I hit the chair during that phony fall in the cafeteria, you and your dopey schemes.
If you were seen wandering about in good health, it could have proved fatal to Miss Kendall.
I've begun to forget her already.
I don't believe you. He doesn't even have a weapon. I'm assuming his plan is to take out Van Damme.
She shot him in a moment of fear and anger. You were there yourself. And thereby wrapped everything up into one very neat and tidy bundle. Leonard?
The gun she shot Kaplan with. I found it in her luggage.
This matter is best disposed of from a great height over water.
But if he takes her with him, isn't Van Damme going to be hunting for her? Van Damme needs to be gotten rid of, or he's always going to be after her. And then Thornhill's in trouble again if she's with him. No! How's he going to get it to her? Is he going to drop it?
There he is.
We're a spoil sport, aren't you? One of my most valuable attributes, as it now turns out.
Long, slow descent. Couldn't ask for a better night than this. Ceiling and possibilities unlimited.
Keeper had me pinned down for 5 minutes before I realized it was that same silly gun of yours. This is no good. We're on top of the monument.
What do we do?
Climb down.
We can't.
What? You can't climb down that, especially not in pumps.
What happened to the first two marriages?
Oh, my wives divorced me. They said I led too dull a life.
It would take you forever to ever get down there. Look out.
Thank you, Sergeant.
That wasn't very sporting, using real bullets.
Now. Come along, Mrs. Thornhill.
Oh, that was so great. I loved it. Talk about a little twist there at the ending. I did not see that cut coming, and that was so awesome. When she was hanging off the cliff and then he pulls her up and Mrs. Thornhill, that was so good. I love me a good happy ending. I love me a good romance, and that was both. That was so much fun. That was so much fun. I'm so glad I watched that. I love Cary Grant. Before this, I had only ever seen him in To Catch a Thief, which I saw probably a couple of years ago now. And I just loved him. He's great. He's a fantastic actor. He's so likable, so charismatic. And I believe this is my first time seeing a movie with Eva Marie Saint. Is it Eva Marie Saint or Eva Marie? I'm going with Eva since it's spelled with an E, but I really liked her. She did a great job as the femme fatale in this movie. But I love that... See, you know, they reveal that she wasn't even a trained government agent, which really took me by surprise. I was thinking of her as, like, this experienced, hardcore, like, FBI agent. And actually, she just made the mistake of falling for a bad man, Van Damme, and then the FBI recruited her once she was already in the middle of all that. And, you know, she wanted to do some good, you know? That part really took me by surprise. I did not expect that twist with her character. She just fell for the wrong dude and then was trying to make up for it, trying to do something useful with her life, something meaningful, and then she finds true love with Roger Thornhill, and that was really, really great. You know, Alfred Hitchcock is a master of suspense. Every film of his that I've seen so far, it's just like a masterclass in suspense, like with Rear Window. Oh my gosh, so many tense moments where you're just like, you're sitting so stiff and you're holding your breath and you're just on the edge of your seat. I definitely had that in this movie. You know, for the first half, first three quarters even, it was fairly predictable with the storyline. But then when it got to that last quarter, I was like, what is about to happen? I don't know. I couldn't tell if it was going to go the happily ever after route or the tragic ending. And I was like, how are they going to get out of this? Which is the mark of a good story. As the author, the writer, director, you're supposed to get the audience to a point where they're like, I have no idea what's going to happen next, and I'm terrified for these characters. I want them to get out of this alive, you know? And it definitely got me to that point where I was like, oh shoot, like, is she going to die? Because I figured that Thornhill was going to make it out, but I was like, surely they're not going to kill Eve. I was starting to wonder when she was hanging off the cliff at the end. But then it cut to that awesome happy ending. So glad. I really liked her character. I loved Thornhill. Great. That airplane sequence was crazy. Like, talk about going the extra mile of sending someone in a plane to assassinate someone. I was like, what is going on? Those shots were crazy where he was, like, running from the airplane. Oh, man. But yeah, just the suspense of it all, wondering, like, what's going to happen. And there was an extra bit of it because, like, Thornhill was not a trained government agent. He's caught up in all this that is so much bigger than he is, and he doesn't really know what he's doing. He's just trying to survive. And he's totally alone. He has no help until the FBI comes along, like, almost at the end, after he's almost been killed, like, three times. And I thought Thornhill made a really good point when he was like, you know, maybe y'all shouldn't be using innocent people like this in your little wars, your cold wars. Maybe you should actually focus on winning instead of, you know, getting all these innocent people involved. Which, I mean, it's so true in real life. Innocent bystanders, often get caught up in things that they never asked to be caught up in. And there's casualties, unnecessary casualties in things like this. And I thought that was a great point there. A great, great point. Yeah, from the point where they got to Mount Rushmore and she shot him, I fell for it for a second. And then I was like, wait a minute. Because I remembered what the professor said about, you know, we have to make him think George Kaplan is out of the picture now, I was like, okay, so he's not dead. But then from that point on, that was when I was like, what's going to happen next? Like, how is this going to wrap up? And it really had me there, because it was from that point on that I was like, anything is possible. Anything is possible. And that was just a really fun adventure. I mean, never a dull moment from beginning to end. Even when I felt like I could kind of like predict how things were going to go generally, even then I was still just really enjoying myself. And I love it when you think you kind of have things figured out and you kind of think you know where things are going to go, and then the story surprises you and there's a little extra twist you didn't expect, and there's a little extra dimension that you didn't predict. This was just a really fun film, a really exciting film. I really, really enjoyed it. So thank you to those of you who recommended it to me. I'm so glad I watched it, and I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. If you want to see the full-length version of this reaction, head on over to my Patreon, patreon.com/MadisonKTames. You can find the link in the description below. So there's not going to be a new reaction next week, but let me know what you guys think about the older reactions that I have in the archive if you're interested in seeing those, and I might be able to get one of those up next week if you're interested before I go on vacation. So you guys might have new content next week. New old content. Let me know if you guys are interested in seeing those in the comments below, and I will see you guys for another Film Friday very soon. Bye, guys.